Changing leaves, changing classes. It all seems so normal here at Belmont Abbey College. Students aware of COVID, but more afraid of what they might miss because of COVID.
I was able to have pretty much all of my classes in person with masks 6 feet apart, and so that was really normal.
And the college itself also ready for a return to normal, or at least something close to normal.
It's trying to do normal. Yes. In an abnormal time.
That's a great way. I'm going to steal that. That's exactly it. We're going to open in person. So this was the intent. We're going to do this darn thing, and this means a lot to us, so let's do it well.
But at Belmont Abbey, normal pretty much went out the window when within weeks, coronavirus came to campus.
And one morning I was running, and I just felt really bad shortness of breath.
Grace Hetzel competes in track and cross country for Belmont Abbey, and when she couldn't finish her morning workout, well, she knew something was wrong as she arrived back at her apartment on campus.
And at that time, I tried to smell my candle and I couldn't smell anything. So I was like, I know what this is.
In the moment, it must have been frightening, a little bit, little bit scary.
Yeah, it was. And the biggest thing was just guilt, especially, you know, at the beginning when it kind of was spiking, a big sense of responsibility. That was the biggest fear, was did I give it to someone else?
The following day, Grace's COVID test came back positive, but by then she was one of hundreds affected.
So really during the first 3 or 4 weeks, we saw a tremendous rise in positive cases. So at our kind of highest moment, we were somewhere between 65 and 68, fluctuating fairly regularly. When we had one person living in a suite with seven other people, we immediately quarantined the other seven. So it wasn't just the 65, but it was the other 150 that were quarantined because of that.
What Belmont Abbey was facing then is the same situation that forced many large UNC campuses to close down.
Pretty good semester, and then, you know, everything kind of hit the fan. And
we caught up with Ryan Prusia on moving out day last school year. When everybody here at UNC Charlotte thought they'd be moving back in August.
Yeah, who knows what's going to happen next year. We might not even come back in the fall.
Yep, turns out Ryan's prediction back in May was right. His move in here at Belk Hall on hold. His senior year online for weeks, as UNC Charlotte told 30,000 students to stay at home and learn at home until October.
Very eerie, just like a dead campus.
But back here at Belmont Abbey, they were also finding out that when coping with COVID, that bigger isn't necessarily better.
In the plus column for us is that as a small campus, I think we have this ability to be nimble.
Provost Travis Fiesel says the college used these temporary modular dorms on campus to quarantine all roommates and other possible COVID contacts, while infected students like Grace Hetzel were isolated in nearby hotels.
I did have some symptoms of like body aches that developed on when I was in isolation. I had just bad body pains and body aches and headaches and things like that, but they lasted for about 3 days and then I was fine.
And as Grace and other students started coming out of quarantine, the number of new COVID cases on campus at Belmont Abbey started dropping all the way to zero.
You've had zero cases among your resident students.
Yes.
Zero among your faculty.
Yes.
And your staff.
Yes.
Wow, after that spike, that's yes. Remarkable.
Was there a moment where we will just call it all off and go home? And our consistent answer was, when we can no longer manage this.
But manage it they did. Belmont Abbey figuring out on the fly how to quarantine 10 times more students than they planned for, how to safely deliver those students their daily meals in person and their daily classes online, and how to keep the rest of the campus up and running, you know, normally, sort of.
Students now began to move into a kind of normalized activity of wearing masks, making sure they were wearing masks, working with each other as peers to say, you need to put your mask on, or social distancing.
I still have no idea how I got it, you know. There was a moment of fear of like, oh my gosh, I don't know what this is and I have it. You see the news and it's this really scary thing. I what felt so grateful when I came out of it, because so many people were so personally in touch with me and I felt so watched out for and cared for. We don't want to get sent home. We all want to be here. Please, like, follow these things, do what you can, quarantine. We want to be here.
For Carolina Impact, I'm Jeff Sonya reporting.
We hope you enjoyed the story. If you don't want to miss any more great stories about the Charlotte region, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.